Hey guys, coming to you from my living room again here, and we're kind of snowed in today, so I thought I'd do a video inside. I've been working on a little project over the last couple months, and it's just about complete, so I thought I'd give you guys a look. What it is, one of my friends here on YouTube, Ken, he's got a channel, 1963 Impala two-door. I'll put the link here. He's actually built himself a rat rod from the ground up, and it was such an interesting vehicle that I thought it would be a good subject for a painting, and that's what I've done here. And as you can see, I've done it in that folk art style that I like so much, just because I can kind of bend the rules on those and just have fun with it. And so I thought we'd just take a look at it. Now understand, the lighting is not the best in here, so it kind of makes the painting look more dull than it is. So what I'll do, I took it outside and took some pictures of the painting in natural light, and I'll kind of interject those into the video here so you can get a better look at what it's going to turn out like. And I still have to put some varnish on it, but for the most part it's done. Ken's truck here is a 32 Chevrolet Confederate pickup, and it's got a lot of unique parts on it. Just for a few, up front here, it's got those heavy glass insulators that he made into some blinkers, and he even made the housings and everything. He took some old rusty chain here and welded the links up, and used that for his headlight supports. And the headlight buckets themselves, he took some really large vintage headlight buckets and then put some other headlights inside of those. And you know, he's really good at working with what he's got around, and I think it turned out really awesome. Up front here, I believe he said this cast iron piece was off of an old stove, and he's just using that to hold his license plate on. Little things, like you see a little bit of green there, that's because where his alternator is, he's actually put a Folgers can over it, and that was pretty cool. And he actually calls it the Rockabilly Rat, so it has a couple parts that actually pertain to that theme as well. Like at, for a hood ornament here, he used an old vintage microphone, and then inside here you can see he's actually got a guitar neck for a shifter, so I thought that was pretty awesome. And then I put Ken behind the wheel with the shades and his black hat on. But I mean, it's just a really cool vehicle, and I'll put a link at the end of the video to his channel so you can actually go check out the real truck, because he sure put a lot of time into it. And over here, just to look at some of the details, you can see I actually painted a cat over here on the fence post, and I painted him in the same colors as the car, and he's actually checking it out as it comes down the road here, or the truck rather. And then behind him there's a little farmhouse with the metal roof, and you can see the curtains in the windows and all that good stuff. And then as you move back a little further, you see the barn. And that little green car that you see peeking out of there, Ken actually has another hot rod, and it's an old Nash, and he calls it the Green Bean. And so that's what that's supposed to be there in the barn. And it's a cool car in its own right. You need to check that one out. And then you see there's a farmer out there in the pasture with the cows. And as we just kind of work our way around here. And then up here in this tree, I added a little squirrel in the hole in the tree there, and it just gives something for people to kind of discover as they're looking at it. And then going along with that folk art style, I did these really stylized sort of trees, these really round trees. And then so when it came to the foreground tree, I did the same sort of thing up here too, and kind of stuck with that shape. And then you got your various fields and rolling hills and everything. Kind of more representative of my area here in Illinois than it is of where Ken's at. Ken's actually out in Washington State. But and then another element up here that I like to add to my folk paintings is a church, you know, an old country church. And it even has the stained glass windows in it and everything like that. And then further back over here, we've got another little farm. And you can just probably make out that there's a John Deere tractor peeking out of that barn back there. But, you know, just kind of the hint of one, basically. But anyway, you'll see. I'll, you know, like I said, interject some better photos of it in here so you guys can see the details and everything. But hopefully Ken likes it. He hasn't seen it yet either, so he'll be seeing it with the rest of you guys. But, you know, it's been a fun project to work on, and I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. Like I said, I just got a little bit of shading to do, and then add some varnish to it, and I'm going to call it done. So, hopefully you guys found that interesting. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you later. Bye.